no hicimos ningún esfuerzo por averiguar qué era lo que estaba pasando, sino que ya a priori condenamos y se manipuló y esas imágenes se repitieron una y otra vez para decir que el chavismo había asesinado o era el principal culpable de la masacre de Caracas.
Ahorita presten atención. Miren, la franela del MBR, este señor del chaleco negro, ¿cómo dispara? ¿Cómo vacía la pistola? La franela del MBR, este señor ha disparado contra los manifestantes que venían en forma pacífica, absolutamente desarmados.
What the TV stations didn't broadcast was this camera angle, which clearly shows that the streets below were empty. The opposition march had never taken that route. With this manipulation, the deaths could now be blamed on Chavez.
While celebrating Mass the next day, Archbishop Romero was assassinated. A number of years later, the National Security Archives in Washington, D.C. made an important discovery when they obtained a copy of a declassified cable. Kate Doyle.
These two cables are both from the American Embassy in El Salvador. One is from Dean Hinton, who was then ambassador to El Salvador in 1981. And it discusses a meeting during which Roberto Daubuisson plans the murder of Archbishop Romero. During the meeting, there is described a lottery that the people who are attending the meeting hold to see who would draw the right to kill Romero himself.
Daubuisson was trained at the School of the Americas. Also trained at the school were two of the three officers directly responsible for the assassination. December 11th, 1981. El Mazote, a small village in El Salvador.
Primero llegaron y dijeron que todos salieran a la calle.
First they forced everyone out of their houses and made us all lie face down in the street, both men and women.
Hombres y mujeres, boca abajo. Y los niños llorando. Los soldados estaban así.
There were soldiers on both sides. Then they moved away to see the women kneeling down on the ground to pray. They killed all of them. Not a single one of them survived. Just me, by the grace of God. I hid under a tree. When I heard the screams of the children, and I knew which ones were mine, they were crying, "Mommy, they're killing us."
Over 900 men, women, and children were massacred. Virtually the entire population of the village and the area surrounding El Mazote. Out of 143 bodies identified in the laboratory, 131 were of children under the age of 12, including three infants under the age of 3 months. 10 of the 12 officers cited as responsible for the El Mazote massacre were graduates of the School of the Americas. They were members of the Atlacate Battalion, a part of the El Salvador Army.
Course ranges that are offered to these individuals, they in fact are a dedicated way of teaching military leaders in foreign nations how to subvert their local communities.
Since it opened, over 55,000 military officials from 23 Latin American and Caribbean countries have trained at the school. About 2,000 students a year. As facts have emerged about the school and its graduates, it has drawn the attention of a growing number of human rights activists, such as Mary Knoll Father Roy Bourgeois.
Just down the road here is this school, the School of the Americas. It's a combat school. Most of the courses come around, revolve around what they call counterinsurgency warfare. Who are the insurgents? We have to ask that question. They are the poor. They are the people in Latin America who call for reform. They are the landless peasants who are hungry. They are healthcare workers, human rights advocates, labor organizers. They become the insurgents. They are seen as el enemigo, the enemy. And they are those who become the targets of those who learn their lessons at the School of the Americas.
What has been learned about the lessons taught at the school? In the 1980s, the civil war in El Salvador became a focal point for human rights activists throughout the world. Death squads operated freely, often killing 50 people a night. There were so many cases that on March 23, 1980, Archbishop Oscar Romero in San Salvador made a plea to the military leaders of his country.
I would like to make an appeal in a special way to the men of the army. In the name of God, in the name of the suffering people whose laments rise to the heaven each day more tumultuous, I beg you, I ask you, I order you, in the name of God, stop the repression.
While celebrating Mass the next day, Archbishop Romero was assassinated.